Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. Today we're going to review a product from William Optics. It's the William Optics Bahtinov mask. Now, if you're into astrophotography, you may well have used a Bahtinov mask before. They're clever devices that look normally like this, and they're invented by a Russian astrophotographer, Pavel Bahtinov, in 2005, and they allow you to achieve a precise focus when you're setting up for astrophotography. So there's something different about the William Optics product. Let's take a look. Okay, so what's inside the box? If we open it up, we've got a piece of protected foam. And under that, we've got the mask itself. So it's shipped with protective plastic sheet on either side. There you go, that's the basic mask. And the obvious thing is it's made of a sheet of transparent acrylic plastic. And I'd say that it is around 2.5 millimeters thick. Feels quite solid. It's available in different diameters to suit a range of different telescope sizes. This one is for an 80 millimeter refractor. And as with most Bahtinov masks, you're gonna be able to adjust it to suit a certain range of diameters by fitting the attachment pins into these three slots. We've got those pins inside a little bag. If we have a look at those, quite a nice feature. Each of them has got a nylon coating, so that should protect the dew cap of the telescope when the mask is in place. So quite straightforward. Put the pin through the mask and tighten it up, and do this for the three positions. So that's pretty standard. So the obvious difference is, really the only difference that jumps out, is that the material's plastic and you can see through it. So what else do we have in the box? Well, it's just standard William Optics warranty card. Otherwise, that's it. So let's put these other pins on, take it outside and see how the performance compares to a traditional mask. So starting with Capella as a target star, which is obviously very bright, I'm using a William Optics GT81. So this is the traditional mask, and you can see that the diffraction spikes are nice and bright, and if we focus the scope, we can see what we get with a normal mask. So it's quite easy to see as the spikes move in and out of focus until we get to a good central position, and that's pretty well focused. So that's the traditional mask. And then swapping to the acrylic mask. Well, obviously straight away it's a much brighter set of spikes, and you can see quite a lot of colour in each of the spikes. Now as we focus, we can see the effect. That's out of focus, then coming back towards focus, somewhere around there, and then out the other side. So I think you can see it's very easy with a bright star like this to get an accurate focus position with the William Optics mask. And then if we look at a 5 second exposure to compare, you can see the relative brightnesses of the two masks. So moving on to a fainter star. So this is around about magnitude 2. This is the traditional mask. So it's a much fainter set of spikes. I have to work quite a lot harder to get a good focus. Whereas if we swap over to the acrylic mask, you still see a good long spikes there. Again with a colour, not quite as bright as we had before with Capella, but still I think it's much easier to focus this sort of magnitude star
with the acrylic mask. And then the 5 second frame, again, fairly obviously brighter with the William optics.
Okay, so what's the verdict? Well, clearly we've seen that the main function of the acrylic mask is achieved. You get a much brighter focusing image with the acrylic mask than you do with a traditional mask. So it's going to make focusing easier, especially for slightly fainter stars. Observations, well, I guess my main observation, my main concern is about the durability of this type of mask. I don't know about you, but I've often located my traditional mask underneath my foot when I've been rooting around in the darkness. So only time will tell whether this one is going to survive that kind of environment. Other observations, well, it's a premium product. Perhaps we've come to expect that. It does the job, it's a premium product, and like every Astro accessory, it's up to you to see if you can justify the expense for your particular application. It's also worth noting, I think, that William Optics are now providing some of their dew covers with these integrated inside the design. And that seems like a really clever idea, because then you've got the option of using the acrylic mask, but also with the protection of the metal that surrounds the mask when it's installed inside the end cap. And then you can take off the central portion to use it or to act as a traditional cover. So that seems like a clever idea. I can see that that is worth looking into. Hopefully that will become more widely available as a separate accessory to buy. So overall, yeah, it's a good product, worth taking a look. So thanks for watching. Hope it's been useful. Please subscribe to the Gems Astro YouTube channel if you'd like to see more videos like this, and hope to see you soon.